way it works when you live on an island is that there aren't really that many opportunities, particularly for young people. So what you find is that the people who really get on, they'll move off the island to go to uni or college, or, you know, they find their own way. But the people that are being left behind, the young people that are left behind, quite often have got lower skills. They're, you know, maybe having some trouble with the family or kind of other social issues. And there was an opportunity to apply for funding for healthy living centres. So this being part of Social Inclusion Project, that was really down our street. So we got lots of partners and lots of people from the community together and say, do we need a healthy living centre on Bute? So that's how the Healthy Living Centre, or the Healthy Living Initiative, was born. My role is project manager of the Bute Healthy Living Initiative, and I'm also a coordinator for the Bute Public Health Network. You need your partners who are engaged with people that you maybe want to engage with yourself and say, how can we address this together?
Jenny, as the project manager for Bute Healthy Living, was one of the first people I contacted to get to know and get to work with. If there is something that I'm thinking of as a gap, one of the things I will do is approach Jenny as someone who may well be able to help me fill that gap.
If you, for instance, think about a course that we do at the moment, like the Looking Good, Feeling Fine course, when we have the kind of storyboard of what we do every week, we also put up a kind of separate thing. It's like, so, you know, this is fine, this is the programme that we do now, but what are the things that are coming up, and what are the things that you feel that you want more of? And we kind of park that somewhere, so that's almost like our needs assessment.
The things I've picked that make me happy are Ollie Moore's, basically because it's music, stars, because I'm interested in looking at stars in the sky, and mobile phones, because I can't live without my mobile phone. And we went on a visit to Benmore as well, and I just absolutely loved that. I'm just thinking back, it makes me happy.
My name is Richard McIntyre, and my job is a project coordinator for a homeless project. Bute Healthy Living Initiative have been able to give some help and advice to some of our young people for making positive life choices.
Breakfast Club is like building up team skills and then like communication and that. Mm. Then it taught you how to work the computers better, and then cooking with Tino.
Unfortunately, they've been really going home and just putting something in a microwave that's ready-made meals, and there's never really been an environment where there's been cooking happening.
Bute Healthy Living Initiative worked with us on that project and really worked around giving the young people a good start to the day, i.e. a nice breakfast and some kind of help and advice along how they could manage their routine and try and get a bit of punctuality back in the routine.
Yes, I do believe I can help people in the cooking business, like Dino's helped me quite a bit, and I would like to, because it gives me an ability to pass on my skills and my experiences to that person. So yes, I would do it in future events.
It's just supporting people to actually make that first step, so that, you know, once they've made the first step, then they could actually do it themselves in due time.
Bute Connections is the social enterprise company that has taken over some of the work from Bute Healthy Living Initiative. There was an evaluation of the Healthy Living Initiative, and one of the things that came out of the evaluation was to set up the social enterprise company. So we pulled together a board of directors from the management group that ran Bute Healthy Living Initiative, which has now ceased because it's now part of the NHS. So that management group formed a board of directors. That board of directors have taken us through registering as a company, a social enterprise company. So we're a trading company on Companies House.
The advantages of developing the social enterprise approach is that we're able to apply for funding that the NHS couldn't do. We're able to make profits and reinvest those profits into the organisation. We're able to be much more flexible probably than they could have been there before, take it into new directions while keeping the ethos that was established by the Healthy Living Initiative.
It's things like the community cafe. There was a cafe running that was quite heavily subsidised as part of Bute Healthy Living Initiative, and we've tried to look at ways of taking that cafe forward in a more sustainable way, where it makes money, where it generates income. We've applied for grant funding to do pieces of work that are out with the remit of the NHS, more developmental kind of work. Those kind of things are the things that we see ourselves piloting and pushing forward.
Well, our involvement with CHEX has been quite a bit over the years. They have had such an impact on the way of working, particularly in terms of community-led health, as well as in terms of looking at the more strategic aspect of health in Scotland.
I think Bute's a fantastic place to be working, a fantastic place to be living, and I think Bute Connections, Bute Healthy Living, and community-led health have got a major role to play in making people's lives feel happier and fuller.
The name of the organisation is the Community Health Exchange. So exchanging information is a key part of what we encourage. We bring together organisations from all over Scotland to our different events. We have a seminar programme and an annual conference, and we encourage people to come together to exchange information, ideas, good practice. I think will always be a role for a national intermediary organisation to support local organisations. People often feel isolated in small organisations, and having the opportunity to come together with other people who have common issues is reassuring for them in the first instance, and it does give them that opportunity to learn from others so they don't have to reinvent the wheel themselves.